Matko Airport, Hungary, 2019. Very interesting weather this weekend. Yesterday we were in front of a cold front with cumulus clouds popping up everywhere around us, making for a almost turbulent thermal environment. Really crazy updrafts and related downdrafts. And that cold front has passed us overnight. We had at least 4 strong storms between 10 p.m. and 4 a.m. And this morning we awoke into cloudy and humid morning. We still could do the remaining qualifying rounds. And now after lunch we had to wait for 1 hour for the remaining showers to pass. Now it's after 3 p.m. and the best 12 pilots are getting ready for the flyoff. As you can see, there are still some cumulus clouds in the air, but it's mostly overcast by some alto stratus clouds, and sun is peeking now through the clouds, heating up the moisture in the ground, and I'm sure we can expect some interesting low-level action in the next minutes. As you can see, this field is huge, open, no obstacles whatsoever. And while we are used to moderate to strong winds here, at the moment it's nearly quiet. Just a slight breeze from the north that I can feel, and air is practically still. So since it's after rain, I have no idea where the pilots will decide to fly. I assume they will go south direction towards that forest, because that's where most of the action was yesterday and even today in the morning. So there's a electricity pole there with some wires, and the field, and then the trees in the back. There are houses that are closer to the camp over there. And there's our pagoda, which is part of our camp, and some bungalows behind it, part of the infrastructure here. So the place is really cool. There's the main building with a fancy tower. Behind the hangar there's a restaurant and a couple of rooms where you can sleep, and toilets and shower. Really cool. And there in the bungalows, there are I think 6 or 8 houses, each suitable for up to 6 people. So everything you need to live is here, including internet, Wi-Fi at the camp and at the airport building. Now we have some raindrops again. I hope it just stays like this and that the rain doesn't get any stronger. But they're starting, so this is it then. So, as I said, no idea where the guys will fly. But, so even the guy that turned left is now joining the crowd to the south of the starting line. So another interesting observation is that while the forecast was calling for a south to west wind and the starting corridor was set up accordingly, we had north to northeast winds both days. So completely opposite of what the forecast was forecasting. Okay, so I see that no one really went low, which is kind of expected. Doesn't make sense to risk a low start in this kind of weather. And most of the planes gathered towards the hole in the clouds. Doesn't look like there's anything in sense of thermals. But people are circling there. Not sure if this makes sense. Not sure if they're gaining height, but I'm sure they're not losing it, so it's good enough to make the full time, I guess. Just staying over there. The whole flock is in that one part of the sky, sticking together, and no one is really willing to get out and explore. But now I feel wind picking up slightly, which may be a good news for those that are the lowest. I think pilots now split into two groups. One is further down and lower, I think, and the other group is closer and higher. At least that's how it looks from here. There's still some thunder rumbling in the distance. But we are very lucky with the weather. At least today. In the morning it looked like the whole wall of storms will completely swamp the area. But they somehow dried out just 20 kilometers south from here. So all we got was a small shower. Five minutes to go. And looks like there's no drama. Everyone has their flights under control. Enough height to do the 5 minutes that remain. looks I was wrong and some pilots decided to land early. Where are the rest of them now? So they now split into two groups even more prominently. A few of them are there in the blue sky. And the other group went towards the forest and the hangar. Let's see if I can zoom on them. Hard to see them even on manual focus. They are now coming back since there's less than 2 minutes to go. And pilots are getting ready to land. Past days this was fun with the crosswind landings, but since there wasn't much wind it was manageable. Also the landing direction is free again, no guidance from the contest director, which means there's a bit of a mess on landing. But so far it was okay. Crashes. So let me now move somewhere over there and with an attempt to capture more of the action down towards the forest. Different perspective now, and wind is picking up. Which means there's something happening in the air. Let's see how pilots will read this. So that tree behind me was making lots of noise. That's why everyone is flying towards it. Looks like now I'm just beneath all the action, which makes it a bit difficult for me. So that's the tree in question. I remember from the past years it was always making noise, while the rest of the forest was hardly moving a leaf. So that tree stands a bit on its own, with lots of air around it. Maybe that's why it's making noise. There's now quite a lot of traffic around here. Practically all the planes are again gathered in just one area. mid-air collision over there could be unpleasant. Doesn't look like there's much of good air, despite the loud tree. I don't see anyone gaining much height. I think this is Radek Novotny with his Explorer looking for something that could save him. So I hope he at least makes it to the point. So what's happening behind me in the meantime? Looks a bit risky or full of adrenaline over there. Guys flying even lower than before, hiding from my view behind the trees and houses. So this guy would do well to go home as well. He will cross the wires, I think. No, he wants more. And there's now one just above me. That is not cool. I wouldn't be flying over houses like that. So, just for feeling what I'm talking about. Yeah, I hear servos now all around me. people are now flying home, trying to make it at least to the point. So that's like flying just over the wires. And again. One more try. Not sure if there's anything to gain. But you know, this is competition. That's now another Airbus A380 making noise above us. You can hear them pretty well even at flight level 400. Looks like he decided he has enough now. Good choice. Okay, home safely. There's another one returning. And is he trying something? Yeah. Again, flying just above me, which is exercise for my back. But I'm not complaining, my back needs exercise. So this guy was on his way home and found something, maybe just 20 meters above the ground. And this will give him additional 4 minutes or so. And looks like he'll now make it till the end. Very cool. He already gained like 10 or 15 meters. That's almost a minute of flying. There are quite a few of planes that found good air in that direction. and pilots didn't need to pump lots of adrenaline in there. Looks like these guys will all make it. Now there's a bird that joined them. Super cool. I always like that. Now they climbed out pretty well. I think it's time to me to move to the landing spots. About a minute remains. I hear there are some complaints already about something that I missed. And planes are now coming in from behind me.
10 seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay. I see 5 planes landed, so at least 5 pilots made this flight.
Starting preparation time in 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Now the sun is out in full. We had a little bit of a break because there were some complaints about the direction of start versus direction of landing. What the organizer did is that they changed the start direction without moving the landing points to the other side of the corridor, which means there was landing over the corridor, and then one of the pilots landed in front of the corridor, not wanting to overfly it at a low height, not risking the penalty for the safety area of 3 meters or something like that. And few others did that, and then there were some complaints whether which decision was right and why the organizer didn't move the points, etc. So this is again directly a consequence of not having a fixed landing direction.
Startup operating time in 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Now starting is the other way. And still all the planes coming over here. I think this is Primož Rižner with a start height of maybe 25 meters. And it will be interesting to see how he climbs out. I can't follow him, he's just right above me. Ok, Okay, he moved now, that's a bit better for me. Looks like they're climbing out nicely. Looks like nobody opted for a stressful, risky, low flight this time. They had enough in the previous round. And I completely understand and agree with them. this flight was only risky and a bit stressful for an initial few minutes. Now looks like it's an easy flight to do the full time. Again, the whole flock is concentrated in just one area of the sky, following the wind direction, I guess, and somehow distributing in the distance, in the direction of the wind vector. Going downwind is the easiest way to find something, but the risk is that everyone is doing the same thing, the chance of collision is higher. I always prefer to fly solo, even if that sometimes costs me good air and I don't manage the full time, but I fly stress-free, which I guess is a difference between a hobby pilot and a competitor. And since this is now getting a very serious sport with the world championship coming up and everything, we see more and more competitive behavior, which again is the natural progress of things, I would say. Can't really do anything about that. There are two planes closer.
Minutes remaining.
And there's 5 minutes till the end of the flight. I see someone is having fun. Thermalink inverted. Why not?
I guess this shows that weather has really improved. Sun is pushing all the moisture up into the atmosphere again. And that's why people can play like this. Okay, back to normal. I guess it's now close to the time to start going home towards the landing points, and I'll move there as well.
In a westerly direction. Planes now coming in from the east.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, this was the third and last flight of today. No collisions, no reflights. We'll just wait for the results.
Amíg a Titus ide nem ér, addig szeretném megköszönni, hogy a sok technikai probléma ellenére ti versenyezni akartatok, és segítettétek a én munkámat. Nagyon szépen köszönöm.
We would like to thank you very much for your help against some technical questions, but you were here for flying and compete, so that's very nice from you, and thank you very much again for your help and for your participation.
Ide álljál, Józsi! 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 Állj ide, és innen pont jó lesz! Dobogót meg odarakod!
Csak egy kicsit behajlítjátok úgy!
Jó, Laci! Zászlóanyján középült!
It's okay?
Tessék, oda az
ajtót.
Olvasod?
Okay. Ifjúsági.
Junior category, 7th place, Alexandru Pipos.
Bravo!
Bravo!
Sorry, only we asked the first three. 6th place, Mirnyich Valentin. Baby left. 5th place Sebastian Samru.
Bravo.
4th Mariam Balasso.
Bravo.
And the 3rd place we ask Mihail Veresegi.
Bravo.
Nem, hazamentek. They left.
2nd Matej Jordan.
Bravo. Bravo Matej.
Nem az. Harmadik. Második.
Úgy van.
Okay, and second place, Stefan Jordan.
Bravo, Stefan.
Igen.
Change position. Change position.
No alcohol.
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, and I would like to ask the six competitors from the senior category, but 12th place, Lazarkov Sotir, already left.
Bravo.
11, Jordan Silviu.
Bravo.
10, Snovotny Radek.
Bravo.
9, Rizner Primoz.
Bravo.
8, Art Herman, already left.
Bravo.
7, Jordan Stefan.
Bravo.
And 6, Hatos Serban Kristinel.
Bravo.
Serban. Ide, here. Okay. 5th place, 8th, Pongrácz Igor.
Bravo.
Thank you.
Congratulations. And 4th place, Horváth Dávid.
Bravo.
Legalább egy jó pezsgőt megisztok.
Gratulálok. And 3rd place, Adamek Juhály.
Bravo.
Még egy.
Fotót
And 2nd place, Karadi Evangel.
Bravo.
Add akkor az a teapest.
And 1st place, Birski Wojciech.
Bravo.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And?
And it is the prize from the contest Euro 2.
Okay, thank you. Lati, okay, okay.
Hold up, 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 up.
Lati, asztalt vegyél be, Lati.
Perfect.
Lati, asztalt vegyél be.
Thank you.
Okay, congratulations. Have a good journey home and see you.
Jó utat köszönjük, hogy
next competition. Jó utat hazafelé, remélem jövőre is találkozunk. Have a good journey home, see you somewhere here in Hungary next year.
Isten veletek!